What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Bazaar. Last week, I put out a video going over 8 noob mistakes to avoid in Battlefront 2, and you guys really seem to like that one. With all the newer players to the game, it's a good topic to expand on, so in today's video, we're talking about even more mistakes that newer players will make. I'll have the first one linked below in the description in case you missed it, and if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing and ringing the bell to get notified of more Battlefront 2 tips and news.
Do it.
So let's check it out. These are 8 more noob mistakes you want to avoid in Battlefront 2. The first mistake to talk about is spending your skill points too early. When you level up your infantry, or heroes, or any other unit, they earn a skill point, which is then used to unlock and upgrade that unit's star cards. The star cards available to the player also depends on the unit's level, with higher levels unlocking more cards. The mistake is spending your skill points as soon as you gain a level and not having any left for the better star cards. Here's an example. Here, I gained some levels on Lando's Falcon and have a skill point available. I already used the first point to unlock the second card, so with the remaining point, I can either unlock that first card too, or upgrade the one I've unlocked already. I'm choosing the upgrade, spending both skill points on the one card. I'd rather have a single upgrade than 2 low-level cards. You can do this with all other units in the game, too. It might be worth holding on to your skill points for a few levels, just so you can level up a really good card as soon as you unlock it. Next mistake to go over is not setting up your controls the way you like to play. In the settings menu, there are a lot of different options you can change that affect your game's controls. You can invert your X and Y axes, you can invert your flight controls, adjust your sensitivity, and change the color of your crosshairs, and a bunch of other things that can help make the game a little bit easier for you. A lot of new players will be excited to play, and will just jump straight into the game, and that's fine. But you do want to take a little bit of time to explore the different settings and options that you can change. You'll want to experiment with settings like aim assist and figure out what works best for you. It's easy to overlook, and if you find yourself having a difficult time, try adjusting some of these settings and see if it helps. You can access the settings menu at any time during a match just by pausing, and you can also access it from the main menu. Moving on, General Grievous is a really fun villain in Battlefront 2, and he's also probably the best counter to newer players. Grievous has an ability called Unrelenting Advance. It's the move he pulls on Obi-Wan in Revenge of the Sith, where he spins his sabers and moves toward his enemy. This ability is a multi-purpose one in Battlefront 2 that can be used both offensively and defensively. When fighting newer players, it's both. The mistake I see them making is trying to attack Grievous head-on while he's doing this. When in Unrelenting Advance, Grievous is immune to lightsaber and blaster damage from the front, and anyone who gets caught in his spinning blades will take massive damage. So many newer players will just keep attacking Grievous while he does this move, and doing that will guarantee Grievous gets that kill. It is not wise to attack a Grievous from the front while he's doing Unrelenting Advance, so just don't do it. If you can get around to his back though, well, that's a different story. Next up, another mistake newer players make is treating every game mode like it's team deathmatch. Battlefront 2 has 10 different multiplayer game modes, and only 4 of them are a team deathmatch type game, those being Blast and the 3 hero modes. The majority of the modes in Battlefront 2 are objective based, meaning there is something else you have to do other than just killing bad guys if you want to win. Team Deathmatch is great, and Blast is a personal favorite warm-up mode of mine, but if you treat the other modes as if they were Team Deathmatch, you just might be contributing to your team losing the game. Getting kills is important, but if you're playing to win, the objective is way more important than kills. By not playing the objective, the game can actually end really quickly, which means less time for kills anyway, so no matter which way you look at it, treating objective modes like Team Deathmatch is not something you want to do. An effective player will want to strive for both kills and good objective play as well. Next, we're talking about star cards again, but this time, the mistake I see people making is not switching their cards to suit the mode or situation. Let's look at everyone's favorite hero, Anakin Skywalker. He's got a good set of star cards with a bunch of different uses, but some of the cards are better suited for particular modes. His Massive Strikes is a good card that gives his attacks more damage, which is a great universal effect. That card would work well in almost any mode. His card All of Them, though, is a bit more situational. It increases the damage of his pull if he yanks a set number of enemies with it. At epic level, this card will let you one-shot all infantry, except heavies, if you pull at least 2 of them. This is a great card for Galactic Assault or Co-op, where you're going to be fighting a lot of infantry, but it doesn't have the same use in Heroes vs. Villains. Sure, you can do a little more damage if you pull two or more villains, but that card slot would be much better taken up by his Steamroll card, for example, which will give him more stamina. You want to always be thinking of your loadout and making sure you have the right cards for the right mode. There's not a single star card in Battlefront 2 that is completely useless, but some cards are better suited than others for different situations, and you always want to be thinking of that. Now, before, we talked about changing your settings, like zoom sensitivity and aim assist, to help you do better, but some of those settings don't apply to certain units and heroes. Some units use weapons that you cannot zoom or aim down the sights with. These include Leia, Boba Fett, Iden Versio, and the ARC Trooper. These units are forced into hip firing, since pressing the zoom button will have either a secondary effect or will fire a second weapon. Some newer players will try to zoom in with these heroes and units only to find that they cannot. For Boba, the zoom controls his jetpack, while Iden and Leia can shoot a secondary fire mode from their blaster. The ARC Trooper fires a second pistol, which is an entirely different feeling altogether from holding down the button to aim down the sights. This also means that your zoom sensitivity in your settings will have absolutely no effect on these heroes or units. Just keep this in mind if you're prone to aiming down the sights, because you'll want to practice hip firing if you're planning on using these heroes. Following that, we have a Droidica tip, because I see this mistake being made a lot by new Deca players. The Droidicas in Battlefront 2 are not quite like the ones in the movies. In the movies, the Jedi run away from Droidicas. In Battlefront 2, Jedi run toward Droidicas, because they're such an easy target. The mistake I see players making with this Enforcer unit is rolling straight into a group of enemies, trying to deploy their shield, only to get melted before the transformation is finished. Droidicas are not a unit you can charge into fights with, they're all about flank routes. You have to come at the enemy from behind or the side so that you can get the jump on them, because if they see you first, they will shoot you before you shoot them. An effective Droidica is one who doesn't roll straight into danger, who uses flanks, and who keeps moving. Once you get your kill, get out of there. And finally, the last mistake to go over that I see players in general doing, not necessarily just new players, is charging into 4 versus 1 scenarios in Heroes versus Villains. HVV is a mode of momentum. When one side starts getting that momentum, it can be hard for the other team to catch up. Like I mentioned before, this mode is a team deathmatch type mode, with a big emphasis on team. The quickest way to lose Heroes versus Villains is to charge at the enemies before regrouping with your teammates. You're much stronger when you have backup and support. Even 2 players stand a better chance against 4 than just you yourself, so if you notice the enemy team all grouped together, find your teammates first, regroup, then re-engage. You'll stand a much better chance together than you do rushing at a team of 4 all by yourself. Now, this can actually get pretty challenging on some of the larger maps like Bespin and Geonosis, where the spawn points are on the far sides of the map and it takes a really long time to run back to your team. At times like that, you'll want to check your minimap and see where your teammates are at. If you notice they're just spawning in, run back to where they spawned in so you meet up with them first. Also, it may sound kind of mean, but if you notice one of your teammates in a 4 versus 1 scenario and they're getting destroyed, sometimes it's wiser to not try to help. It's better to run back to the other teammates who are spawned in, and then come back and engage your opponents together. It sucks for that one player, but all that would happen is they would get defeated, and then the 4 versus 1 scenario would just move on to you instead. So, in Heroes vs. Villains, always regroup with your team first. And with that, those are 8 more noob mistakes you want to avoid when playing Battlefront 2. Have you made any of these mistakes yourself, or have you seen newer players making other mistakes I haven't mentioned in either video? Let me know in a comment below, and if you like this one, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Once again, the first video is in the description in case you missed it, and if I get enough good suggestions of other mistakes noobs make in the comments, I just might make a part 3. But stay tuned guys, more Battlefront 2 tips and news is on the way. Be sure to subscribe and get notified. I appreciate you stopping by the bazaar, and I'll see you all out on the battlefront. Peace.
Master Windy, was you weren't ready to...